Kampala. Children have been burned down, no investigation. Markets have been burned down, no investigation. Hospitals have been burned down, no investigation. We are here to represent them. What can we do? What tune should we play in order for the world to know Ugandans are suffering? Ugandans are suffering. He has rigged elections and nobody seems to talk about it. How many dead bodies of Uganda do you want us to present to you? We need your journalists to go and count them, because there are thousands. They are not being buried, but there are thousands. People are afraid. A man who is very corrupt with his wife, the children, the brothers and sisters. There is a man who is loose right now. He's in South Africa. He's talking to all of you. And yet the whole world knows East Africa, there's a problem. We see people are dying in East Africa. And this is the same man who is getting your money to go to give it to another place. We are here to represent Ugandans. They are very voiceless. Ugandans are voiceless. We are here to represent them. We want you to take action. We are not asking too much. We are not asking for bombs. We are not asking for bombs and fighting bombers. We are asking for free and fair elections. Elections that have been rigged is useless. We don't want useless elections. We are here to say, please stop the genocide in Uganda. Please come to the northern Uganda and help the northern Uganda. Please come to Kampala. All the children have been massacred. Tear gas has killed people. Only a month ago, the police commander, in his own words said, I am putting the people because Britain told me the app. America told me the app. Please, we are asking you to stop that man. He's misusing the power. Someone is misusing the power. They are not using the constitution. Ladies and gentlemen, 25 years the man has been on the ground. Within his room, you have genocide. Millions of Ugandans have died. We are here to represent the voices. We are here to represent the voices. If you are going to live here because they said Benghazi, they were going to kill the humans. Ugandans have already killed them. You want to eat it, the nation said 30 years things have gone. Uganda has gone beyond that. What are you waiting for? Gentlemen, parliamentarians, my parliamentarians, please do something for Uganda. Your help, your one word will scare that man. Your one word will scare that man. The people do not want guns. The people want to be left alone. We have done enough damage. This same man has done damage in Congo. The man has done damage in Rwanda. He's trying to help. We are here to show to you, Ugandans. Ugandans are really desperate. Dead bodies and thousands, they are being killed and nobody can talk. Time has come now. When someone disappears, nobody talks about it. No one talks about a dead body. Humanity is not there. So we now have two tiers. Uganda life is now useless to the world. We stand here to say, is a Ugandan one? Is a Ugandan life bad? A Ugandan life is any ordinary life. It's a human life. We stand here to say no to that. We should be here, no. It is the reason why we are standing here, to represent the voiceless. Those who are voiceless are not going to talk. When you talk of East Africa, you are talking of Somalia. Because you can see the Somalians dying. I would want you to come to Uganda and see what's going on in Kampala. Come and see what's happening in the eastern Uganda. Come in front and see what's happening in the northern, western, eastern, probably in the west. In the west is a very corrupt man. His neighbors, the brothers and the sisters are all driving Rolls Royce instead of an ambulance. When you see a commander, when you see the ministers, they have looted. And what do they say? The so-called East Parliament said they have been forgiven. There's no criminal law in Uganda. you are giving it to this corrupt man. This corrupt man who is determined to destroy people. Only a month ago he destroyed everybody. The things are getting bad now. No investigation. So many people have died in silence. In behind me you can see pictures of women who have been shot by the police. The police commander agreed. He said it's because Britain sold them the arms. He said we should go and ask Britain and America who have sold him the arms. Is it a man whom you can keep follow? Isn't it not enough to say let's stop this? We can stop this by a free and fair election. We stand here very firm with the voiceless Ugandans to say we demand elections, free and fair. Nothing less, because anything less than this, you are encouraging, you are betting genocide. You are doing that, and that's why we are here standing firm in front of this parliament. This is the parliament that authorizes money. That money is the one that is being given to people to buy fighter bombers. Uganda has no war. The war is created by this same man. I stand here, next time you look for me, this is the same man who is masquerading as a peacemaker. He is the troublemaker in the whole of East Africa. The entire Congo, go to Congo and find out what has happened in Congo. They actually found Uganda guilty of genocide. They found Uganda guilty of destroying the human race in Congo, raping the women. Let's leave Congo alone. We are here standing in firm. We said we need free, fair elections from dictatorship Museveni. Museveni has stayed 25 years. We don't need that anymore. Gone are the days of dictatorship. We need this. Ugandans are voiceless. Ugandans can't talk. They will walk and look away. They know what is going on. It will only take one person. We are not going to talk Jesus. We are just going to tell you, Uganda has no journalists because they will all be put in or they will all be killed. After all, you are not going to see their dead bodies. You are not going to see dead bodies like in Libya, like in Egypt. You won't see them. This has been going on for 25 years. We are saying no, please give help to the people of Uganda. Please give support to the people of Uganda. If you need, this is a global world. This is a small world. A small world where you cannot simply enjoy and see somebody dying. Uganda is a good country. Uganda doesn't need your money. Nobody, no critics that should ask you money for Uganda. Because Uganda needs democracy. Democracy will bring money to Uganda. Everybody will build up their own things from their sweat, not from stealing from you. $300,000 on the 2 days ago, this guy gave it. And on the TV, he said, please donate £5 for East Africa for famine. This is a joke. It is a big joke until someone is going to come up. We have stood here, we want you to understand there is a problem. We need to solve this problem where the source is, and the source is in the State House. It is State House that is betraying Uganda. It is State House that has destroyed the entire country. The whole market in Kampala is burned down. Some primary schools we are burned down with children. No investigation. So many people have disappeared, died. No investigation. Ladies and gentlemen, please don't forget Uganda. Let us not forget Uganda. We need free and fair elections. Let us stand for free and fair elections, because there's no point you giving in money and hypocrisy. You are giving one hand here and he's giving it away to his other friends. He's giving it to one.